Hello guys, welcome back to the new episode of Road to Redis. In this episode, I will be telling you about how to configure Redis on Windows using WSL Linux. So let's get started. Okay guys, so first of all, we need to search in our search panel. You can type optional features. Then in this window, we need to open this more Windows feature. When you open more Windows feature option, you need to search WSL. Let me search WSL. Okay, so there will be Windows subsystem for Linux. Sorry, not WSL, Windows subsystem for Linux. And you just need to mark this option. And you need to, when you mark the option, it will ask you to enable this option. And you need to turn on this option to install WSL to use Linux on your Windows system. So we need to install a Linux on our Windows system to configure Redis. So there are two options from which we can get Linux on our Windows system. So first is directly open the Microsoft Store and then type Ubuntu. I'm using Ubuntu for this tutorial. You can use any Linux for configuring Redis for your system as per your requirement. So I'm using Ubuntu, and when I type in search box Ubuntu, then there are multiple versions available to install Ubuntu on your Windows system. So like I have installed a simple Ubuntu version, it's already installed, so I can directly open it. You just need to click install. It will configure it, install it, and make it ready on your Windows system. So the second option to install Ubuntu or WSL Linux, Windows subsystem Linux on your Windows machine is to first open PowerShell, and then you can write a simple command WSL. We can do like this. Sometimes WSL is work fine for you, and sometimes you need to type WSL.exe -install -d Ubuntu, and it will do the same procedure as you are installing directly from a Microsoft Store. So this is the second way to configure Ubuntu on your Windows machine. Once your Ubuntu have been installed on your machine, you need to launch your Ubuntu on your Windows system. So you need to just type in your search option Ubuntu. So you can see there is a Ubuntu app which is installed if you have installed using a Microsoft Store or using a PowerShell command. Same Ubuntu, we can say shortcut, you can see in, you can start menu. So when you click on this Ubuntu, it will launch your Ubuntu. So you can see the Ubuntu is launched simply. So this is how we can configure Linux to install Redis on our Windows system. After opening a Ubuntu on your Windows system, we need to install Redis. Before installing a Redis, we need to get the latest packages, like for example, all these stuff Ubuntu needs. So first we need to run the command is sudo apt update. So it will fetch all the updates which are available on streams and other stuff. So after running an update, I have already ran an update. So it's telling us that there are 60 packages can be upgraded, run apt list that's upgradable to see them. Okay, so if you want to do the upgrade or you want to see the stuff which is like, for example, is ready to get upgrade, you can type apt list and type upgradable. So it will show you all the apps and utilities which are ready to get upgrade. So at the moment, I don't need to upgrade anything. So let's get moved toward installing a Redis. So we need to run a command to install Redis is sudo apt install Redis. Okay, so I already installed Redis. So Redis is already the newest version 5.6 and blah blah blah. The version is already installed in my Ubuntu. Okay, so after the installation of a Redis, you need to run the Redis. So you need to run a command sudo systemctl and start Redis. And when you type Redis, it doesn't print anything. So how do you know that that the Redis is running or not? Then you need to run the same command, but instead of start, you need to check status of Redis. So you can see the Redis service, redis-server.service, is running. Okay, so on default, Redis starts its server on 6379, or we can say on which we can connect to Redis is 6379. So if you want to connect and see that our Redis is working fine, we need to connect with Redis. We can type redis-cli, and you can see you have connected to 127.0.0.1 6379. It means Redis is working fine. You can test it Redis like as per the documentation in given in Redis. You type ping and it will return you pong. It means Redis is working fine. Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you like this video. So keep supporting and subscribe my channel. Thank you guys.